Hi. Still now, whatever you have learned, that is all basics only. Now onwards, Nyquist topic is going to start. So here, what is Nyquist counter? So we have seen different counters mapping, right? But Nyquist counter is one constant counter. Let us see how it will be. So this is S plane, this is real axis, and this is imaginary axis. So Nyquist counter is, you need to start from zero, origin, and you need to go with imaginary axis. Clockwise direction, okay, and you need to reach infinity. Then this infinity circle radius is infinity. So this is infinity, you need to reach to negative imaginary axis minus infinity, and you need to travel with negative imaginary axis to zero origin. So clockwise direction you need to travel. This is the Nyquist contour or contour A, or also called Nyquist contour. For this contour, by using some transfer function T of S, if you map, you will get some contour B, right? This is contour B. So for this contour A, specific like this only you need to take contour A or Nyquist contour. For this Nyquist contour, by using transfer function, if you map, you will get contour B. This contour B will call Nyquist plot. For this specific contour, if you draw contour B, this contour B also called Nyquist plot. You should not take any different contours. You should take only for this contour only you need to map. For you will get Nyquist plot. Then how it become a frequency response plot? So let us see here. We will take transfer function. So while mapping, you need to take points, each and every point in the counter A, right? So if you observe here, we are covering entire imaginary axis. Imaginary axis is j omega. You are varying j omega, means omega your frequency 0 to infinity you are taking, right? So here omega you are varying points 0 to infinity, okay? And this is entire infinity only. This entire infinity same point, okay, and minus infinity to again you coming back to zero. So for plotting Nyquist plot or for plotting counter B, you are varying omega from zero to infinity and minus infinity to zero. So you are varying only omega, okay. That's why you call frequency response plot this one. So now onwards you need to conclude that every Nyquist plot will use this contour only. Thank you.